Hello everyone and welcome once again to the channel. My name is Ranier Triple8 and in today's Division 2 video we're going to show a build and some of its variants that are perfect for the global event that is still active, Hollywood. The build and all of its variants are perfect to run for heroic difficulty with all 5 directives active to gain the maximum amount of XP you can, especially useful for those that plan to farm the global event during the 2-3 remaining days to get the maximum amount of global event credits and get those name casses, exotic casses and anything else you plan to purchase. Without any further delay, let's have a look at the build and its variants. Let's have a closer look at the build. We're going with the sharpshooter specialization. I honestly had underestimated the power of the signature sniper rifle because I thought you only have to go with headshot in order to one-shot enemies, but if you hit the enemies it hits for 4 million and crits from 7 to 8 million, and for headshot it hits for 13 and crits for 17 to 18 million with this type of build, one shotting everything that is not a named enemy. Also, by gaining access to the sharpshooter, we gain potential unlimited ammo while we remain in cover for rifles or mag machine rifles, but I prefer rifles for this type of build because we're going with glass cannon to increase the damage for all our weapons, not only our signature weapon, instead of perfect hunter. That's a better fit where you go with Mark Machine Rifle builds. Once again, 4 pieces of tip of the spear to gain extra damage for signature weapon. Weapon damage generate, automatically generate signature weapon and deal increased damage, specifically with the mask, holster, gloves and backpack. Everything has weapon damage, critical hit chance and critical hit damage. And the backpack has the unique talent that increases further the damage of your signature weapon and also doubles the amount of signature weapon you gain, making it perfect for this event. For our chest piece, something that has glass cannon, I had the best piece I had was a Walker and Harris that is a god roll when I reroll one of the attributes and has, as I told you, the glass cannon that will increase all our damage, including our signature weapon damage. For the knee pads, because we're going with rifles, the Overlord named item, the Fox Sprayer, has the unique attribute 8% damage to targets out of cover, which is perfect for this type of build. For our weapons, I'm going with the Virginian for my primary choice, is a named rifle that has the perfect boomerang. Every time you do a critical hit, you have a very high chance to get the bullet back and does increase damage for your next shot. It has a very high damage and very low ammo count, it's very efficient. And my second choice is the Baker's Dozen, another rifle that has also high damage, long range, and it has a perfect lucky shot, making it also ammo efficient. Every time you miss a shot you get back. And for my sidearm, I'm going with the Orbit. It also has a very decent amount of damage and also the perfect finisher. Every time you kill an enemy with your sidearm, you can switch to another weapon and gain a ridiculous amount of critical hit chance, critical hit damage, allowing for very high damage in combos. And finally, for our skills, I'm going with a fixer drone. Once again, because we're going with glass cannon, we need to increase our survivability. And for the second skill of choice, it's open to your preference, but because I go with scavenge skills, I prefer something that has a long duration. That's why the soul turret is a perfect fit for me. It has high health, decent damage even with skill tier 0, and help you distract 1-2 enemies, because that's basically its purpose. Let's have a quick look at the stats. We have 58% critical hit chance for all our weapons. The only thing that changes are the critical hit damage, hit damage, and the range. For the Virginian, we have 83% critical hit damage and 28 meter range. For the Baker's Dozen, we have 94% critical hit damage and 60 meters range. It's perfect to pick very far enemies. For our sidearm, 69% critical hit damage, and the same amount for our signature weapon that has 70 meters range, that you can kill the targets that are almost located across the map. The second build is almost the same. We go with a gunner specialization instead to gain access to the minigun, and because we have to fire it outside of cover, that's its only downside. We have to replace the glass cannon, it's very risky. Even without glass cannon and the bonus armor we get and the armor on hit we get with the minigun, it's very hard to survive if you get pincer attack or attack by many enemies. Apart from that, the gun specialization gives us armor on kill, extra reload speed, extra ammo, which is perfect to run with all directives and ammo hoarders. Primary weapon of choice was again the Virginian for the high damage, low ammo count, perfect boomerang to get almost all our critical hits back, and combined with a gunner specialization, we will never run out of ammo, even with ammo hoarders. Your second weapon of choice is open to your preference. I go with the exotic pestilence, the light machine gun. Otherwise, you can choose another LMG or an AR. the Plague of the Outcast is it's not the, I think, the best build for the Pestilence, but can be one of the best potentially. It scales very well with all reds and all the rest of the items. We have replaced the chest piece with the tip of the spear to avoid having the glass cannon. And we also replaced the gloves with the named Petrov Defense, the Contractor's Gloves that has a unique attribute and percent damage to armor and extra LMG damage. Apart from that, everything else is the same. The skills and the stats are a little different. We only have 52% critical hit chance for all our weapons compared to 58% critical hit chance that we had with our previous build. The final option is almost the same as the first one. We only change the demolition specialization to have access to the grenade launcher, and everything else is the same. The weapons, the pieces, the gear pieces, the chest piece to have the glass cannon. We only change the gloves to have the China Light Industries to have further increased explosive damage to increase a signature weapon, and you can change the core attribute to weapon damage if you find decent gloves, although you are free to leave skilled here as you gain access to a very decent skill you can use, which is the artillery turret. Even with tier skill 0, you have 4 artillery turrets that deal 1 million damage. It's quite good to remove the shields and help you finish off the enemies. Although the ideal pieces was to find 2 Kurbo Sombras to have 50% critical hit damage and 15% explosive damage. Although I wasn't lucky enough to find a chest piece that has a group of Sombra that has decent attributes and glass cannon. That's why I had to go with the Walker and Harris and China Light Industries for gloves. The primary weapon of choices remain unchanged, the Virginian and the Baker's Dozen. They have very high damage and they're very ammo efficient, perfect to run with ammo hoarders, and that's why they remain unchanged. As far as our stats, they're almost the same. We have the same amount of critical hit chance for all our weapons, 57.1% for everything. Only things that change are the critical hit damage, headshot damage, and the range. These builds are perfect for this global event because every time you kill a shielded enemy using your signature weapon or explosion, they will always drop either grenades or signature weapon ammo. This means that every time you clear a territory with your signature weapon, there is a very high chance for them to drop more signature weapon ammo, and that helped me clear many activities without switching to my primary weapons and only using my signature weapon ammo as a primary source of DPS. I have also tried the other signature weapons to see what works. Unfortunately, the rocket launcher from the technician specialization, it seems nice and it can be either perfect or very bad, because sometimes even the guided missiles will miss if you are close or away. I don't know the reason why they miss. Even if you lock on the target, you just run around and miss the target, making it less efficient, and you will run out of your signature weapon ammo very fast. And also the crossbow, it's also very good or very bad because it can one-shot enemies while behind cover for its area of effect, but unfortunately sometimes or many times the enemies will just be able to dodge the signature weapon AoE damage, making it miss the shots once again. And finally, the Firewall Flamethrower needs a specific type of build because you need to go close and personal. I don't know if Tip of the Spear is the perfect fit. You will need a combination of more armor, more skilled gear, something like that, or the Memento to just have improved shield, the Crusader shield you get in from the specialization, to be able to go close and personal and use that flamethrower. But in my opinion, you can also run a very good Hunter's Fury set with the Scorpio, which is perfect for this event, and also have the Firewall specialization, which can be very quite nice, but the playstyle is completely different and you will probably run out of your signature weapon ammo faster. Not only these builds are very efficient to run with all 5 directives for maximum XP gain, they are also very fun personally to run because there is a perfect opportunity to run an exclusive signature weapon, primary source of DPS build 90% of the time. You will get so much signature weapon ammo by killing enemies while having the global event active that you cannot do it normally, and it's a perfect opportunity to have fun, kill enemies using your signature weapon and clear activities while gaining the maximum amount of XP you can. Some tips while running these builds: be aware that ammo hoarders do apply for these builds, and be careful if there is any ammo remaining while you reload your signature weapon, you will lose it. I know this speaking of experience, and there is an efficient way to reload them. Just switch to your primary weapon, wait around 1 second or two, switch back to your signature weapon, and it will be automatically reloaded without losing any single bullet. When you face named elites, be aware the signature weapon does reduce damage and it's very hard to finish them off. That's why conserve your signature weapon, use it to just break their shield and make use of your primary weapon of choices to do maximum amount of DPS to break their armor and finish them off. This also apply to heavy elites. Be aware they are sponges for signature weapons. You can use them to break their armor, break their defense, and use your primary weapon to finish them off quite efficiently without using all your signature weapon. And finally, sometimes occasionally you will be running low of signature weapon. Either you're missing some shots, some enemies won't drop as much signature weapon as others. Don't worry about it, use your primary weapons to finish off especially normal enemies and conserve your signature weapon to deal with elite enemies and heavy enemies, and every 60 seconds you automatically generate 2 full charges of signature weapon, and that will help you go on the fight. I really hope you like this video and find it useful, or at least help you make a build on your own to farm for this global event that will remain until Monday, and it's your last chance to get those caches or any of the other items you may need by farming the global event credits. Feel free to leave your comments, suggestions, and anything else you have to add in the section below. Stay tuned for more upcoming videos for The Division 2 and other video games. Thank you all very much for watching, happy farming, have a great day and a wonderful weekend!